the border has never been as bad as it is right now. And that's like intersecting right with this funding fight over border security. Russ, if Republicans can't get this done, when there's 8,500 people illegally entering an Eagle Pass alone, I mean, it's not as if this is something that happened 6 months ago. This is actively occurring. Then Republicans are completely worthless. Russ, so what is the ask, and strategically, what is your advice for how they actually get it done?
So my view is that they have had a wonderful banner, a messaging parameter called no security, no funding, that allows them to be able to go at this seminal threat that we're seeing along the border and to make that a very, very important issue. I also think it allows them to deal with the weaponization at the Department of Justice. I don't think that this we can leave this leverage point without doing something against the regime that is trying to steal the next election and at the same time going against half the country and considering them enemies of the state. So I think there's a lot of things that can be done, but if we don't get to the end of this process and have dealt with those two issues and then spend a lot of time trying to defund the offices doing the bad activities, I'll consider it a failure.
So, but then the goal needs to be then not paperwork processors on the border, but actual border security. That's a major difference. But also, I think that the pressure needs to be that Joe Biden needs to start deporting these people. He's hosting them and just releasing them into the interior of the United States.
Exactly. And that there's a specific rider that needs to be put in place. And Stephen Miller has been calling this for this some time, as well as Chip Roy. It needs to be illegal in the sense that you can't spend the money to be able to release someone into the border. That's the kind of thing that it's not just about changing laws that they ignore. It's about saying that a bureaucrat is going to be facing criminal charges in violation of the Anti-Deficiency Act if they ignore the appropriations law that's saying that they can't do that. And as a result, that will change a lot of the policies that we've been asking for.